Friends, here our concept is executing commands on remote server. See, already we know how to log in into a remote server using SSH. Now, we are using that SSH to execute our commands on remote server. But there are two ways to execute your commands on remote server using SSH. And these two ways are applicable for your both password and passwordless authentication environments. Let me go with the first way. So here we have some steps. Let me go with step by step. The very first step is, first you have to log in into your remote server. We know how to log in into remote server. Simply SSH, username, @ remote server IP or fully qualified domain name. And after running this command, if your environment is passwordless authentication, then directly it will log in into your remote server. Suppose if your environment is password authentication, then it will prompt for password. Let me show you that. Suppose I have two servers, two remote servers, and those two remote servers I saved in this file. Let me take one of the server and copy it. Now see, for my this first remote server, I have a user called automation. That's why simply SSH automation user @ IP of that. And if I enter, it is asking yes or no confirmation, like adding fingerprint to your local server or about your remote server. Whenever if you try to connect at very first time, then only it will ask. But I don't want to display this information. Without asking confirmation, I want to make it as by default as yes. Then for that, there is a option with your SSH. Simply search with man SSH. So here, if you observe, there are different options. Just to go down somewhere, you have -o. -o option is there for your SSH. And in that, we have number of options. Based on requirement, you have to select your required option for your SSH. Now, my requirement, I will show you. Just to go down. In last, you have somewhere a strict host key checking option. I want to take that. Just to go down. See that? Strict host key checking. Just copy it. Now, I will show you how to use that. So, if you run in this way, right, it is asking yes or no, but I don't want to ask this. I want to make it as default as yes. That means you don't need to ask this yes or no option. So for that, you can run simply SSH -o strict host key checking equals to no, means don't ask. That's it. Now if I enter, see that without asking yes or no confirmation, it is asking password. Now let me run, let me give the password for my remote server. Now you logged with your remote server. Now you can run your command here, any command, and you can see the result. And in case, once if you've done your work, then you can exit the session. You can close the session connection by using exit command. Now you are on local server, right? So these are the steps for your first way. But this is not good for automation. If you want to implement some shell script such a way that your shell script has to connect with your remote server, then this is not the good way. This is only for manual steps. Whenever if you want to verify manually, you can use this procedure. Now, then what is the other way for your automation? See that? Simply the same, nothing is there, clubbing all these steps. SSH, username, @ remote server. Then here at the end, I am providing in quotations command. That's it. And anyway, if your environment is passwordless authentication, directly it will execute your command on remote server. But if it is password authentication, then it will ask, it will prompt for password. Let me show you that. Same steps. Guys, I will use this -o, whether you are going to connect at very first time or not. Always, I will use from here onwards for your SSH -o with option as strict host key checking equals to no. Then, same syntax, SSH, username, @ host name, colon, space, not colon, space, in quotations, you can write any command. Then enter. Anyway, as of now, my environment is password authentication environment. That's why I need to provide a password here. Automation password. I have given that password. Now see the result. You are getting output for your command, date command. And this command has been executed on this server by using this user. That output it is displaying. Now, whenever if you run your command without SSH option, then your command is running on your local server. But if you run with SSH by providing user and some host name, now your command is going to execute on this server and after execution of your command, whatever the result you are getting, that result will be get back to your local server by using your SSH. That's what it is doing. But it will ask password. That's it. Now, instead of displaying this output, you can store into a variable or into a file. You know how to store the command output into a variable. Suppose I am taking a variable called server 1 date. Just for your understanding, I am taking that lengthy variable name. Then dollar parenthesis, inside that just write your command. See that? It is asking password. I am going to provide the password. Now, whatever the output you got from this command, that output is stored in this variable. Now you can display that variable so that you can see the value which is there in that variable. That's it. In case if you don't want to store into a variable and if you want to store this command output into a file, you know how to redirect a command output into a variable. Now simply greater than, suppose server 1 info.txt. Be clear. Your command is executing on this server, but result is storing on your local server. You should be clear with this. Your date command is executing on the remote server, but the result, whatever you are getting the output for this command, that is storing into this file, but this file will be created on your local server only. Now let me provide the password. Now see the result in the server 1 info.txt file. That's it. I can run some other command as well. Let's say I want to run uptime, but I want to redirect that output also into my server 1 info.txt. But I don't want to delete old content. I want to keep my old content as it is, and I want to append the new command output into this file. That's why I'm using double greater than. Now just run it and provide the password. That's it. Now see the content which is there in your file. So previous date output is there, now present uptime output also there, right? See, if your environment is passwordless authentication, then you no need to provide password while running your SSH commands. But sometimes, you know, for some environments, there is a passwordless authentication. For some environments, they, in case if you don't have passwordless authentication, then you have to provide this password. That's it. Now, let me run one more command. Suppose I want to run a command called top on my remote server. I want to see load. I am providing the password for my remote server user, but it is saying that term environment variable not set. See, actually, you know, whenever if you run top command, it is a terminal interaction output. See that it is not ending your session, right? Whenever if you run top command on your local server, you have to press Ctrl C to close that. So some commands you need an interaction with your remote server terminal. So in that case, you have to provide one more option for your SSH, that is called hyphen t. Now see the result. I am running the command top on my remote server. Now you are getting output for your remote server. Anyway, if you want to close it, just press Ctrl C. That's it. So that your remote session closed. So if you are getting confusion, always you can take hyphen t, whether it is a top command or date command. But for date command, you need hyphen t. Yeah, maybe I have given wrong password. Let me verify it. See that you are getting your output. So after getting your output, this is automatically closing your terminal. Hyphen t, terminal is closing after getting your output. So this command output also you can store into any variable. Without hyphen t or with hyphen t, you can run your commands and you can store that output into a variable or file. Let me store into a variable. New output equals to dollar parenthesis, your command, SSH command, close the session. Right? Now see the result in new out. Yes, you are getting your date command output. So actually while running this command, your command is executing and you are getting your output. At the same time, you are getting some info connection to your IP closed, but this won't store into your output variable or into a file. Be clear, only the command output into store a variable or into a file. Right? So guys, this is the way how we can execute a command on your remote server without logging into it. But here the problem is always you need to run, always you have to provide password. Suppose I want to run 5-6 commands on my remote server. For each and every command, you need to provide a password. That is somewhat a disadvantage here, but we can overcome that in our next session. We will see about that. Now, suppose if you want to run multiple commands at a time, yes, we can run it. There is an option. So simply just separate your commands with semicolon, date, uptime, memory usage. Now it is asking only password at one time, but it will execute three commands. See the result, your date command, uptime and RAM usage. So this is the way how we can execute multiple commands simply with semicolons. Right? Okay. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video.